Welcome to another Unity Quick Tip. Today I'm going to be demonstrating how to vary random timing in Unity using animation curves and particle system min-max curves. Most examples of random timing usually derive from random.range with the minimum and maximum float values that don't change. Here's an example of that. I have a script here called launchshipsrr. Let's take a look at that in Visual Studio. In start, we set a timer to a random amount between 0.5 and 1. In update, we subtract time.deltaTime times 2 from the timer. If the timer is less than 0 and our launch count is less than 25, we launch a new ship. The timer is reset with a random range of negative 0.75 to 0.75, which is added to a baseline of 1. This gives us a range of 0.25 to 1.75 seconds. I could just set the range from 0.25 to 1.75, but the next example also uses a baseline variable. Once the new timer is set, we increase the launch countdown by 1, and the timer starts counting down again. Here's how that works. So it's working. Ships are launching randomly. Some launches are closer together, others are further apart. Even though the launches are random, it's still pretty static and mostly pretty even. That's because statistically, the launch times are always going to average out to be the same. What's missing is rhythm or intensity. If you think of music, this random method is a bit like a metronome. Over time, the launches are going to tick away at fairly even, predictable intervals. Let's look at how we can change that up. Here's a second script called launchshipAC. Now, unlike the first script, which had launch times, this one has mod launch times. Not because we're going to modify a variable returned by this animation curve. As you see, this curve starts at a value of 1.5, and as we go along the curve, it drops down to 0.4 and goes back up to 2. And this is over a range of 0 to 1. So let's look at the code and see how that works. The start time and timer countdown is the same. We're adding a new variable here called percentage. This calculates the value from 0 to 1 as the launch count increases. Next, we use the evaluate function of the animation curve, passing it the percentage variable. This returns the value of the curve at that point along the x-axis of the animation curve. Next, we modify the baseline value by the random range from the mod launch times variable. The last thing we do is make sure our next launch time doesn't end up with a value of less than 0. If you pull the curve down far enough on the animation curve, that could happen. Let's see how this looks. The randomness in the beginning is similar to the first example. You'll see the launches increasing in speed, then spiking before they start slowing down. And now the launches are tapering right off. So that's using animation curves to increase the frequency of the launches, which helps create a rhythm or a beat for waves of attackers. While the animation curves help create a rhythm or intensity, the random range still stays the same. Our modifier is still going to have a range of 1.5 seconds. I'll show you how you can take this even further with particle system min-max curves. Our third script here is similar to the launchshipAC, but it has a few notable differences. There's no baseline variable, no random range modifier, and we're using a particle system min-max curve instead of an animation curve. This uses two animation curves. The bottom one is the curve min, while the top one is the curve max. As you can see in the sample curve, each line has 3 points and the distance between the lines can vary. You can add more points and have the lines as close or as far apart as you want. Like animation curves, you can return a value from min-max curve by passing two floats as parameters. The first parameter is the x position on the graph from 0 to 1. The second parameter is the lerp factor from 0 to 1. 0 will give you the value of the curve min at position x, while 1 will give you the value of the curve max at position x. I'm using random.range to get a random value from min to max. In this animation, the yellow dot follows the curve min line. The red dot follows the curve max line. On the right, you can see their respective values. As the time increases, not only do curve min and curve max values change, but so does the range between them. From 0.5 down to 0.05 up to 1. Let's see how that works when applied to ship launches. As time increases, the min-max values drop, and so does the range between them. Soon, the number of ships will spike before tapering off. Particle system min-max curves are a great way to vary randomization visually. They can create rhythm or intensity for enemy attackers, waves of ship, shot patterns, and more. When you're editing an animation curve or particle system min-max curve, you can pan around by holding down the Option or Alt key and dragging with the mouse. You can use the scroll wheel to zoom in and out. If you use the Shift key with the scroll wheel, you can zoom in and out along the Y axis, while using Command or Control with the scroll wheel scales along the X axis. This makes it easier to zoom in and fine-tune points along your curves. That's it for this video. I'm Mark Sweeney. Thanks for watching.